trigeminal neuralgia is a condition which essentially comprises often agonizing, debilitating electric shock type pain which radiates into the face. It can be on either side, either around the eye, near to the nose, or down towards the chin. It can be intermittent, it can be constant, but it can be so severe that it has been called the suicide pain, because patients have been driven to suicide due to the agonizing nature of the pain. They can commonly be misdiagnosed with problems with their teeth. So these patients will commonly present to their dentists, and often by the time they come and see somebody like me, they will have had multiple teeth extractions with the idea that by removing the teeth, the pain will go away, but the pain hasn't gone away. It can be triggered by normal everyday activities such as eating, teeth brushing, even the cold wind on the face can bring it on. And so these patients become reclusive, they stop eating and drinking, and generally it's a very, very serious and debilitating condition. It can be caused by medical conditions, such as multiple sclerosis, for example, but it can also be caused by surgical conditions as well. Sometimes there may be a growth or mass lesion of some sort pressing on the trigeminal nerve, which can cause this condition. But also, it can be caused simply by a vascular loop, a normal loop of a blood vessel that we all have, but in this particular patient's case, that loop is pressing against the trigeminal nerve, and that is causing these exacerbations of pain into the face. And that's a condition that I commonly treat in this hospital, surgically and with good outcomes. Treatment for trigeminal neuralgia can be less interventional, or it can be more interventional. And that would be determined by the patient's symptoms, but also the patients themselves, as to whether they're fit for what would be a rather complex operation. But if the surgery goes to plan and the offending vessel is moved away from the trigeminal nerve, then there's a good chance they will see a very good outcome from their surgery. And that would be life-changing, of course, for the patient. Normally with trigeminal neuralgia, you would try to treat it medically first, and there are some medications that you can take which can control the pain or certainly make it more manageable. But the problem with those medications is that they can have quite troublesome side effects. But if the medication is effective and well tolerated, then you would potentially leave it at that and continue that way. If on the other hand the medication is ineffective, or the side effects are intolerable, or the patient's lifestyle or work means that they can't be taking medication like that, then they sometimes will then seek more interventional options, and so they will come and see me in clinic. And in terms of the surgical options, well, one option being a percutaneous procedure, where whilst it's under general anaesthetic, it's not an open operation, it's an insertion of a needle through the cheek to cause damage to the trigeminal nerve in essence, but by damaging it you replace the pain, often with numbness or tingling, which is better tolerated. But if patients are otherwise in good health and fit for an anaesthetic, then we would also talk about the merits of a procedure called a microvascular decompression, which is a complex skull base brain operation, which takes about 3 hours. Patients are in hospital for a few days, but it carries a high chance of improvement or resolution of the pain, and long-standing resolution for many years, maybe even for the rest of the patient's life. And so if the symptoms are severe enough and having enough of a detrimental effect on that patient's life, then the potential risks are really outweighed by the benefits. And so we would talk about that, and if that's a procedure that we both feel is the best option, then we would proceed to that shortly after the consultation as an inpatient here at the hospital.